there, welcome back. I have an empties of June. Hey there, I'm Brittany, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. It's free. I have a June empties, though. I love empties videos. I love watching them, at least, because you get a nice review of them. I'm just gonna go really quickly through this. The first thing is a surface color. It's a strengthening, I think this is the conditioner. It's very expensive. You get this at a salon. You can't, like, buy it through, like, Ulta or stores like that. It made me break out. I won't be repurchasing, but if you don't have sensitive skin and don't break out over, like, hair stuff and literally everything in the world, it smells really good, and it's supposed to be really good for your hair and, like, not have a ton of chemicals in it, so I can't use it, but you might be able to. I think the branded stuff, like, I like what they do with it. Let's do, I think, another hair thing. This also made me break out. I'm very sensitive, I swear. This is Redken, the hair cleansing cream shampoo. It's like a clarifying shampoo. It makes you feel very clean. A tiny, tiny bit drying, though, so I won't be repurchasing that one. I also went through a Miss Meyers Clean Day. This is in the scent lavender. I didn't love this. I felt like it was really watery. I'm just not a huge fan of their soaps, at least. I do have some of their cleaning supplies, which I like, but I am for sure still on my Bath & Body Works soaps. But I guess this was like a skincare, hair care month for me, because I went through a Dermalogica Daily Microfoliant. This is like, it's weird because it's a powder, and it obviously mixed with water, it turns into like a regular exfoliant. I liked it. I did not like the scent of it, though. I don't know. I think Anthony turned me off to the scent after he said it smelled like what they put in the urinals in the men's room. And I was like, oh. And that's all I could think of afterwards. But overall, I felt like it was like good for sensitive skin. Like, it wasn't a super like hard exfoliant. It was more of like a soft one, if that makes sense. So if you have sensitive skin, but you also kind of need an exfoliant, it'd probably be a good one to at least test out. I went through a Smarty Pants Adult Probiotic Complete. This is a gummy. I have a problem. I've admitted I have a problem. I love gummies. Vitamin gummies. They're just like it's like eating candy, and it's good for you. But also, it still has sugar in it, so is it that good for you? I don't know. I'm trying to get off of them at the moment. Workout-wise, I went through BCAA Amino Tropical Pineapple is the flavor. This was nice. I've never went through a Woman's Best BCAA that I haven't liked. And right now I'm going through watermelon, and oh my goodness, I think that's my new favorite. I wasn't gonna say scent, but flavor. And they accidentally sent me two in my last shipment, and I only got charged for one. Excuse me, because I only bought one, and they gave me what was the buy one, get one free? So I got the free one, and then I got another free one. So I am doing really well in the BCAA department. I also went through an L-glutamine. I don't know how to say that. It's basically you put it in with your, what I do, I put it in with my BCAA, and it's supposed to help with like muscle recovery and like just not losing your muscle. I'm not a nutritionist. Don't take my word for it. Just like Google it, and you can see if maybe it'd be good for you or wouldn't be. I'm going through creatine right now. Again, I don't think I pronounce anything right, so I apologize. This is just from DNC. The packaging was like really minimal, and like it was calling my name, but I know you can get this in a ton of different brands. That was only like $14. I didn't think that was bad. I went through a L'Oreal Extraordinary Clay Conditioner. I always go through these. I always, like, that's my go-to hair product because it does not break me out, and like the scent is really nice. I just, you have to trust me and you have to try it. Aloe vera smoothing mist, 98% pure organic aloe. This is if you want to think of, like, if you have like a face setting spray, that's what it feels like. It's just like a mist. It doesn't really have much of a scent. Like, you can tell it's not water, but it's a really nice, if you have sensitive skin, like, I'll spray it on my face if I'm feeling dry and I don't want to put like a moisturizer on, anything heavy, just throughout my day when I'm not wearing makeup. You can use this on makeup too. It can be a really nice, like, hydrating setting spray. It's not gonna make you oily. I don't know. I just love this stuff. I couldn't remember for the life of me where I got this. It was either Whole Foods, Fresh Thyme, or Kroger's. And I thought it was from Kroger's, but like, can't find it. So I ended up ordering one on Amazon, not this brand, but like a different brand. I wanna say I like this one more though. So when I go, I got a huge bottle. It's gonna take me years to go through. Well, whenever it expires, but I want to find this one again because I really love this. I also went through an Ole Henriksen Balancing Force Oil Control Toner. This is just like, yo, what I do is when I'm not wearing makeup for the day, I'll just like rub it on my face. I'm feeling a little oily. So it's a control your oil. I didn't really notice that much controlling it, to be honest. I'm just like an oily person by nature. I think I strip my skin so much, it makes me even more oily. So I'm like working on using oils on my skin to help with oil, and it's still like, I'm not there yet. Like, I haven't fully went on the I'm in love with face oils yet, but I'm hoping at some point, if it works, I'll get there. I went through same brand, Ole Henriksen. This is the Counterbalance Oil Control Hydrator. It's just a very lightweight face moisturizer. Did not make me break out. It did not make me super greasy either. It's very, like, it's very lightweight. I would for sure purchase this again. Right now I'm going through a ton of face moisturizers. So I don't have a need to buy it yet, but it will be a product that I will repurchase in the future. So if you struggle like me with acne or oil and you need a moisturizer, I would try that one. I went through more. I didn't realize I had this much of it in here, but this is a Find Your Balance Oil Control Cleanser. I actually already bought a new one of this. Like, I really like, you guys don't understand, I like this brand a lot, and it's not super expensive. Like, it's a high-end product, but on Sephora, it's like one of the lower-end price-wise products, so I felt like comfortable buying it. I think I got it during the VIB sale. Like, I went ahead and like stocked up before I went through this. So this is just really, again, like lightweight. It doesn't strip your skin. It has green fusion complex neem seed oil, glycolic and lactic acids, green fusion complex. I can't read the rest of that, but I don't know. I like this brand. I like this line, the oil control. I didn't notice a huge amount of oil reduction. That's the only thing I can't say. If you're like specifically looking for oil reduction, you probably, like, it's not gonna do much, but for me, like, it just helped with, like, acne is the reason. I break out over a lot of things, and I don't seem to be breaking out over this line. Oh, I went through a tattoo liner by Kat Von D. This was a mini sample. I think I probably got in a subscription a long time ago, or from, like, Sephora, like, a travel size sample you get sometimes with purchasing things. I have the full size. I'm going through that right now. I actually have that on my eyes. I really love that eyeliner. It's just a pin liner. You need to try it if you want like a higher end product. Lower end though, Essence Superfine eyeliner. Oh my goodness, I love that too. I probably love that the same amount, and it's only $2, so go get you some Essence. I went through a Wallflower. My nose is failing me because I don't know what scent this is. I'm gonna assume it was like a fall product scent because I think I only bought Wallflowers in the fall scents, like pumpkin something. I don't know. I'm gonna get more because I no longer have any, and I went through all of them. So once fall hits, you know, I can pick up some Wallflowers now because I'm no longer on a no buy for those. Chapstick once a month. That's, oh, last thing, this is weird. This is a Nippies skin, so I don't actually have them in here, I already threw them away. But what this is like my favorite brand. Like, I've never found a brand that was better than this. But they're just little silicone nipple covers, and they're very thin, which means they're not gonna show through your shirts. Cause sometimes, like, I've bought in like nipple covers that are thicker, and it just makes you look like you have this really thick nipple. And it's like worse than just like not wearing a bra at all. So I will link to this. Not a sponsored, I'll have just like repurchased and repurchased from this brand, and I've been getting them on Amazon, so I love it. If you are looking for nipple covers, like, I highly recommend this. And that was everything. I am going to head out. I will see you guys super soon in the video. Leave me any suggestions below if you have like any product recommendations. You know, I mean, if you watch my empty videos, you know what I go through, you know what I like and what I'm looking for and what I'm not looking for. I bought so much stuff over recommendations from you guys. I love it. I love you. I'm gonna leave though because it's very, very hot and I am burning up and I need to get out of this window sunlight. Okay, goodbye. In a dream.